also of my wife. So we are back in another episode. As usually, we give a couple of minutes to share the link. Yeah, so as we wait for our viewers
to log in
and my job is also now to share, sharing the link. Yes,
yeah,
we have about 2 minutes before we start. Wow, we have already 2 people. Please comment in the chat room so that we know who's... Shanti, Hari Om, Shanti. Hari Om. Thank you so much for being here. We wait for the rest of you to say something in the chat room so that we know you are with us. We have 3 of you. Good. A good start.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm sure there will be friends from Indonesia joining us. So we like to wait for you to comment.
Yes.
And also, please share this to your friends, to your colleagues, to your neighbors, and
how are you, YouTube?
Okay, I'm good. Yeah, thank you so much. We are about a minute away before we go for the interview. Meantime, we hope that you can share this to your friends. It's a very important topic, and we have a friend all the way from Indonesia. So what we're going to do now is we're going to start in about 30 seconds.
Yes.
So meanwhile, please share. I'm going to share this onto my wall as we wait for people to join. We have 5 of you. Thank you so much. I can't see who is...
We have our Dr. Gopi is here already.
Okay, our regular Dr. Gopi. Okay, we have 7 of you here.
Yes.
Thank you, viewers. Excellent. Please share. Very important topic. And we have our dear friend from...
all the way from?
All the way from our neighborhood.
Yes, and last year.
And all the way from our neighborhood.
Yeah.
Arsana is here, but we will start officially.
Yes.
Okay, alive to be live. Hari Om, namaskar. Okay, namaskar, Dr. Gopi, namaskar. All right, let's start the interview.
Hari Om, namaskar.
Hari Om, namachivaya walga, nathan taan walga, ime poludum yen nenjil, ninga dan taal walga. Hari Om, Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Shri Ram, Jai Sakti, Namaskar, Namaste, Namaskaram, Vanakkam, and Om Swastiastu to our friends from Indonesia.
Yes.
Yeah, so now I like to pass the floor or the screen to my co-host to say something, because today she wants to introduce our guest. Yeah, over to you, ma'am.
Wow. Okay. We have someone today special. Last week we had another Hindu wonderful person from all the way from Mauritius, and we spoke about karma.
Yes. Karma.
And today we have another special person. You know, in Malay language we call it Tulin. Tulin is pure, the pure Hindu. And we are so happy to have you here today, sir. And who that person is, very special, Pak K.S. Arsana, all the way from Hindu plus Asia become Indonesia, and it became Indonesia. So that's how the Indonesia came from. Okay, let me introduce him to our viewers here, and our fans are waiting to know who is this, our K.S. Arsana. K.S. Arsana was born in Bali. I'm not going to tell them your age, but he never lived in Bali. He grew up in Lampung, Sumatra Island, and now lives in Jakarta, Indonesia. K.S. Arsana is a management consultant, trainer, public speaker, human resources assessor, and counselor, and business coach. Graduated with a Bachelor of Psychology from UGM, which is a well-known university, and a Master in Education at the Hindu University. I love the word, Hindu University. Okay. you got all his experience and expertise in human resources development, strategic management, and soft skill management, holds several international certifications in the field of human resource development. But a long list here, you know, and just try to make it short. Founder and managing director of Human Dynamics, a consulting company engaged in human resource development services and organizational development. Co-founder and business coach at business coach. At successful
same
business.
Same field. Yeah. Yes.
Successful Business 360, a digital business academy and incubator company. Developed himself and share knowledge, experience, and expertise to various countries in 5 continents: Asia, Australia, America, Africa, and Europe. Since a student, active in organizations, are involved in social activities, including interfaith activities on a national, regional, and international levels, serving several social organizations, including the president of DPP, or the Prajantali Hindu Indonesia. I remember you gave us this badge. The chairperson of the communication and international inter-institutional relations and Parisada Hindu Dharma Indonesia. Vice President of the GHF and the U.S. Indonesian Society. Wow, I've got a long list, but I will go on later. Yeah, thank you for that wonderful profile, and thank you to have. I mean, we are happy to have you here. Welcome, welcome, Pak K.S. Arsana. Now over to you.
All right, before we invite Pak Arsana to say, please like our page, please share before we start. Yeah, all right, Pak Arsana, thank you so much. The floor is yours.
Introduce yourself first, tell thank us you. About you.
Yes, all yours.
Om Swastiastu, Namaste. Namaskar, Vanakam, Jai Sri Ram, Jai Krishna, Om Namo Shivaya.
Om Namo Shivaya.
Thank you. Thank you, Taya Ji and Krishna Ji, for this session. I have to share a short my knowledge on the 4 Purusa Atas, Dharma, Artha, Kama, and Moksha.
Yeah,
but okay. Before we discuss on the this topic, please allow me to share a shortly about Sanatana Dharma, also about the people, human being, because we discussing Purusa Artha is discussing about ourselves as human being.
Yeah. Pak Arsana, before we move to the topic, we want to hear about how you, what attracted you into Sanatana Dharma, how you got yourself engaged into or got yourself involved into this Sanatana Dharma, the world of Sanatana. You are a Sanatani yourself, so please tell us that first.
Okay. I was born as Hinduism with a father and mother, of course, Hindus. But my surrounding neighbor is Muslim and Christian.
Oh.
Since okay. I was child, I joining Muslim ritual.
Oh, okay, okay,
that's
okay.
That's interesting.
And when I was in junior high school, I was appointed become a chairman of the Muhammad ceremony program.
Okay. That's interesting. Yes.
I happy to do that. But I feel I'm Hinduism, that I don't know everything about Hindus. That starting on the junior high school, I tried to look at my knowledge about Hinduism personally and autodidactically.
Mm.
Then come again with the knowledge on Hinduism. Much I study about Hinduism, much more knowledge I don't know yet. So very interesting and challenging to learn Hinduism.
Was there, you had a teacher or you learned it all within your friends, yourself, or you looked for it?
Yeah, your voice is not clear for me.
Oh, I was asking you, how did you come about learning about Hinduism? You had friends teaching you, you had a teacher, or you were seeking this knowledge from where? Can you hear me, sir?
Mostly I seeking knowledge by myself by buying some books and now through internet.
Okay. Oh, okay. How young were you when you started seeking. How young?
About 12 years old.
What? Wow. 12? Okay.
12.
All right. Okay. So continue. Yes. About your journey.
Can we start with the
slide? Is it slide?
Okay. Yes, slide. The first slide on the page 2. Sanata Dharma, when I learned about Hinduism, actually the real name, the native name of Hinduism is Sanatana Dharma.
Yes.
Okay.
Sanatana Dharma mean eternal truth, eternal natural way. Since it is natural way, it is not just belief, but a real way in the universe. Sanatana Dharma is represent the values, code of ethic, philosophy of life, and tradition of spiritual path to lead human being to this spiritual awareness. Searching for awareness of life and its meaning, higher consciousness from the pure self-identity awareness and awareness of spiritual unity of soul and supreme, Atman and Brahman, is the peak of human needs. So when I learn Hinduism or Sanatana Dharma, the basic we have understand is we are spiritual being. That one point. Unlike at the next slide.
Okay, thank you.
Unlike other religion, Hinduism or Sanatana Dharma has no single scripture, but many.
Yes.
We have 4 Vedas. Rig Veda, Ayurveda, Sama Veda, Atharva Veda.
Yeah.
We have 108 Upanishad. We have Vedanta Sutra, the explanation of the 4 Veda. We have Itihasa.
Yes.
We have Bhagavad Gita, the philosophy about this life.
Yes.
We have Purana, and we all also have Dharma Sastra, like Manava Dharma Sastra.
Yes.
The Veda contains of 2 hierarchical knowledge. Paravidya, the higher knowledge about Atman Brahman, and Aparavidya, the knowledge about the world, this material world. Next.
Can we say the spiritual world? For simple understanding, spiritual world and the material world. Can we say this?
Yes.
For a layman understanding. Yes. Yeah. So two yes. Vidyas. One is the paravidya and the one is aparavidya. So paravidya is for the spiritual world, and aparavidya is for the material world. Simplified for the layman.
We have two knowledge. Spiritual knowledge, we see, and material knowledge.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay. Got awesome. It. Awesome.
Yes.
Next, please.
Next.
Okay. In general, Hinduism has 5 basic principles. It's called Pancha Shraddha. Pancha is 5. Shraddha is belief. It consists of 1, believe in Brahman. Brahman is God.
Yes.
Believe in Atman.
Yes.
Soul, which is our natural self.
Yes.
Believe in Karmapala, the law of causes and effect.
Yes. Yes.
Believe in Samsara.
Yes.
Or Punarbhava, the incarnation. Yes. And believe in Moksha, self-liberation.
Okay, Parsana, can I ask you this question?
Yes.
As Hindu, how many gods do we how many gods do we have? Do we have one god or we got 33 million gods? Because some people with no brain, we need to teach some people who got more brains.
Hindu has one god, but unlimited form.
Forms. Numerous manifestations.
Numerous manifestations.
Yes.
So this is for message for people who got their brain at their knees.
Yes.
This was the flesh who got their brains in their knees.
And
they only read one paragraph. No, they read to choose which paragraph.
Yes.
You got 33 million God. So for these donkeys, is to tell them that Hindu, we only got...
Donkeys don't read books.
Oh, okay, sorry. Sorry, donkeys don't read books. I understand. So it's fair to call them donkeys because they don't read.
Yes.
So that's the right thing to say.
Yeah.
So unfortunate. So I said the right thing.
Yeah.
So I'm not wrong. I am not wrong to tell these donkeys because the donkeys don't read.
Yes.
So they no fault of theirs.
And
so
we
excuse them. We excuse them. So Parsana, we are very clear.
Exactly.
How many God? One God.
Parabrahman.
Yeah. So please take your pens.
God.
No, let me finish. Let me finish. For this verse, take the pen, dig their ears, both sides, dig their nose. And please listen to this. Hindus got only one God.
Yes.
If you heard 33 million God, this means you are a donkey who have not gone to school properly.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So.
And we have many school of thoughts. You just said.
So it's very clear.
Yeah.
We have many forms, but Paramporul in Tamil, we call it Paramporul. Parabrahma. Only one.
Yeah.
If you still cannot hear, please take lock and dig. Maybe a toothpick is not enough. Take lock and clear on your ears. Okay. Very good, Parsana. You clear one very important point. Next, over to you.
Thank you. Then next slide.
Yes. Yeah.
As the our knowledge, that spiritual knowledge and material knowledge, this the reality also consists of two aspects.
Yeah.
Spiritual world and material world. Human being consists of this both spiritual and material, soul and body, Atman or Sarira.
Yeah, Sarira.
Atman and Sarira. Atman is soul, Sarira is body. We, human being, is spiritual being with human body.
Okay, one
this
more time.
Important to...
One more time. Say that loud and clear.
Yes, please.
We are a spiritual being living in a human body.
Can you hear us?
Correct.
Exactly.
Yeah. So very, very, very clear.
Correct. So let's go more deeper to the our human being. Next slide.
Next slide. The human soul
already,
with three bodies.
Yeah.
Okay. Let we go more deep. Human being is a soul with three bodies.
Okay.
Because a lot of people don't know more detail. Only Hindu tell us with more detail.
Yeah.
Yes.
Soul is the spirit, eternal.
Yeah.
Body is material, maya.
Yes.
Not eternal.
Yes.
Now let me explain more deep about the body.
Okay, the body. Okay.
Human being not only have one body, but we have three body.
Yes.
One is gross body or physical body.
Yes.
This is physical body.
Yes.
Parsana.
Yes.
And I say this is a physical body.
Exactly.
What you can see is the physical body.
Yes.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. And the second The second body is our mind.
Okay.
Our mind. And the third body is our intellect.
Okay.
Which is we mostly do not remember we have intellect. In simple word, these three body can explain our body, our head, and our heart.
That's what Vedanta teaches: body, mind, and intellect.
Intellect.
Intellect. This is
those who talk about this 33 million God. They got no intellect.
Yes. You hit the nail.
They got only body.
You hit the nail.
Yes, they only know
they
body.
They only got body. They don't have anything else.
Okay.
Because the brain also now at the knees. So that also got missing. Okay, very good.
Okay, very good.
Yes. Okay.
The second body of the mind.
The mind.
According to Bhagavad Gita, mind is our close friend, but also our worst enemy.
Very good. Say that one more time.
One more time.
Make sure people understand. Okay. Your mind is your?
Our mind is our best friend.
Yes.
But also can be our worst enemy.
Worst. Why you say so? Why is it say so?
Because if we have not clear knowledge on these issues, we will fall down as a human being.
We will what?
Fall.
We will fall down. Okay.
Hindu teach us, for example, Hindu teach us all people are brother and sister.
Okay.
But sometimes other religion teach us other people with other religion is our enemy. No, Hindu not teaching this one.
Yes.
Correct.
Hindu scriptures, Hindu books, no one, our gurus, our sage, our munis did not tell us that, you know, about this. Yeah. Okay, go ahead, sir.
Yes. Please, next slide.
Next slide. Okay. That's why Swami Partha Sardhi says this book is called The Fall of the Human Intellect.
Yes.
There is a very famous book. Yeah. I like this. Dr. Gopi said, like donkeys,
Swami only body works. No mind and intellect to get clear knowledge.
Yes.
Most people in the world are choosing to be
donkeys.
Mr.
Gopi, I can introduce one donkey in Malaysia to you if you like.
Yes. Okay. Okay, go ahead.
Go ahead, Pa. Yes.
Okay.
Sorry, it's yours.
Yeah. Since we consist of soul and three bodies, we have four level of needs.
Okay.
Natural need. Four level of need. One is physical needs, like we need space, we need air, we need food,
yes.
We need water,
yes.
etc.
And many more, a lot more.
Second, a lot more. But not only physical needs, we have another three needs.
The second one
is psychological needs.
Okay. Physical needs,
like
psychological needs.
Yes, like feeling safe, accepted by others, recognized, appreciated, and loved or to be loved.
Okay, right.
Psychological.
All right. Feeling safe, accepted by others, recognized, appreciated, loved. Okay, very good. All right. Next one.
The third need is intellectual need.
Okay, intellectual needs, yes.
Intellectual need is related to our intellect.
Okay.
Our capability to think. creativity, knowledgeable, aesthetic, that all is intellect. And one more need, which is spiritual needs.
Okay.
We also sometimes forget about this spiritual need. What is spiritual need? Like meaningful life, happiness, self-actualization, and self-transcendence. The awareness
of your
spiritual being.
Sorry, Pa. What is the difference between self-actualization and self-transcendence?
Okay. For example, Pa Utaya,
yeah.
If you have a naturally hobby with the music, and Mrs. Krishna hobby with the cooking, you actualizing your potential as human being on the music or in cooking.
Okay.
Maximize our potential.
Okay.
While self-transcendence is awareness, we are spiritual being. We are spiritual being. Other people and other creatures also, there's Atman or soul there. This awareness is self-transcendence.
Okay.
Can go further?
Yes.
Please, next slide.
Next slide, yes.
Okay. This human being is naturally, yes. We born naturally with needs. With
okay.
This four needs.
Four needs.
Need. Yes, we have four.
Four, okay.
Need, form, drive to achieve goal. Three elements there. Need, drive, and goal.
Okay, three things. Need, drive, and goals, okay?
These three elements is interact and depend each other. And interrelated to form motivation.
Okay, what is motivation is? So because I'm in the field of motivation,
yes.
So motivation means there must be a need. Yeah? And then it must be driven to achieve goals.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Motivation consists of three elements.
Okay, three
needs,
elements.
Drive and goal.
Okay.
Are we having motivation class yet?
No. We're just explaining what is motivation.
I like it.
It's
go ahead.
Motivation class.
Go ahead. I like it.
Being a Hindu already motivated.
Yes,
being
already
a Hindu already motivated.
Yes.
We don't need external motivation.
All right.
Because we know our purpose of life.
Yes.
Yeah, Pa.
Okay. Can continue?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Setting goal give us direction, long-term vision and short-term motivation.
Okay.
There's two type motivation, which is intrinsic motivation and extrinsic motivation.
Extrinsic motivation.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
Intrinsic motivation, which is the motivator from within the individual.
Okay.
While extrinsic motivation, the motivator from outside the individual.
Okay.
Any question?
So intrinsic means motivation from within.
Yes.
So which means...
Exactly.
They don't need an external stimuli.
They are self-motivated. Is that
yes?
Right? Okay.
Yes.
How does
for
it
example,
happen?
For example.
Yeah. Okay.
If we joining a religion because we want to go to the heaven, this is extrinsic, not from within.
Ah. okay.
It's not external, just like
no,
how
no, it's external.
The extrinsic is external.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the earlier when he was talking about the intrinsic is like you at your age of 12, you already seeking. So it was self motivated. You were self motivated, right, to go and learn about Sanatana Dharma.
Yeah.
It was self.
Exactly.
Yeah. All right. Okay.
The in motivation, intrinsic motivation, self-motivation is more powerful than extrinsic motivation.
So being a Hindu, is it intrinsic or extrinsic? Extrinsic.
If we the real Hindu,
yeah.
If people joining Hindu as a real Hindu, the motivation mostly from intrinsic motivation.
Intrinsic, yes.
From intrinsic, yes.
Because we becoming Hindu, not want to go to heaven, but we want to know more deep ourselves.
Ah.
And nobody forces to do it.
Yeah. Because some people in this world joining a religion because with interest to go to heaven, not to knowing themselves.
You know who is talking about going to heaven?
Some people join religion because they will get a job.
Some people really
extrinsic motivation.
Yeah.
Some people join a religion because long time God never helped them to get money, so they go and join this God because God is a part-time broker. Yes. So what God give them job, God give them business.
Money, business.
So that's called
a comfort life.
So a real Hindu,
exactly.
No need to use God to be a broker. Correct, Pastor.
Okay.
Huh? Correct, huh? Yeah, okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Go ahead, sir.
Let's go next.
Yes, next one. Next slide.
Please.
Yeah. So we come to the topic.
The topic today.
Yeah, the real topic. Now we have landed the real topic.
Yes.
The four purushas.
The earlier was just an introduction.
The introduction already very exciting.
Yes. So let's move to the topic today, sir.
Thank you. This statement in Hinduism that we use in Indonesia.
Yeah.
Moksartam jagadita yechaiti dharma.
Okay.
Dharma guide people to attain material well-being and spiritual happiness. This is human goal,
okay.
Human being purpose.
Okay.
And this statement come down to four purposes we call four purusha arthas.
Okay.
Which is from the basic one, dharma, artha, kama, and moksha.
Yes. Okay, for all those who are listening, sir. For all those who are listening,
yes.
Just tell us where did this come from? Which book does it come from? Manu?
In a lot of Hinduism book, this stated clearly.
Just for all our fans here, our viewers here, I wanted you to say that.
Let me explain one by
Thank
one.
You.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Dharma provide foundation for a right and regulated living. Because without Dharma, there is a lot of trouble in the personally or in the society or in the world.
Hmm.
Okay.
Dharma is basis to go to our peak or ultimate goal, moksha. To understand, to aware that we are spiritual being. Between Dharma and Moksha, there is another two, Artha and Kama.
Okay. Mm.
Artha and Kama is necessary stepping stone towards spiritual goal, Moksha.
Okay.
Dharma is necessary requirement for artha to be meaningful and the abundance of artha will needed to support karma. The path to liberation or enlightenment of moksha supported by harmonies of interaction dharma, artha, and karma.
But why
is all is important?
Let me stop you for a while, Parsana. Why was me moksha? I don't want to achieve moksha. Can or not?
Yes, please.
You are every segment. We are not supposed to. Three of us are not supposed to use the word moksha. He seems to be using it in every segment.
No, I'm not using. I'm asking you because if I don't achieve moksha, because one person threatening me don't achieve moksha.
Three of us.
So
three in the team.
Okay. If I why must I achieve moksha? Why?
Because we are spiritual being.
We are.
Because we are spiritual
being. We are spiritual being.
You have to be
so
one.
Our ultimate goal is awareness. We are spiritual being.
That to be liberated.
Yes.
Okay.
But continue.
Yes. Sometimes some people only focus on moksha. They forgot about the other purpose. This is important. Becoming Hindu with the ultimate goal of moksha, not becoming a poor people. We can become a rich people, material well-being, but at the same time we also don't forget our ultimate goal is awareness on the spiritual being.
That's our ultimate goal here. That's what we are supposed to do. Yeah. Okay. We have to get there. We have to reach there. You like it or not, you have to reach there.
No, that's our goal.
Yes.
That's you have to
our
go.
End goal.
Yes.
But the process. But the process is
not okay. One birth.
No. Can I share this? Can I simplify this? Correct me if I'm wrong, Parsana.
Please.
Our end goal is to reach moksha.
Yeah.
Yes.
But we start with living a dharmic life. This universe has a certain law, certain moral values that we must subscribe to. So we live this dharma or dharmic life. As we live our dharmic life, we must, it's okay to build our artha.
Yes, economic part.
Economic part, so that we can fulfill our karma or pleasures.
Yes.
Because many people, they like to say, I don't want anything. I will meditate. I want to meditate. I want to reach moksha. So they sit down and home and do this. Oh, my electricity in my house, 2 months, noche pay. Oh, my car, my house is the installment, 3 months, noche pay. Om, tomorrow lunch, don't know what to do. Om, so some people have this wrong idea about spirituality. They want to reach the end goal, but
without
they
going
don't
through
going
the
through
steps.
The process.
Yes. Okay.
Can I say this, Parsana?
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
So in Hinduism, it's okay. It's okay to become rich. As long as you don't, as you do within
your dharma.
Sorry, Pak, continue. Says, you wanted to say something?
As Hindu,
yeah,
we can become a rich people with ethical way.
Correct.
Based on dharma.
Yeah. Correct. Very good. So to clarify for some of our viewers here, as a Hindu, it is okay to become rich. It's okay to fulfill your pleasures.
Yes.
But you must do it, confine it within our dharmic.
The dharma that has been assigned or allocated to you, because you have to fulfill the dharma righteously. Correct? Is that correct, Chapa?
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
The simple meaning dharma is do something ethically.
Okay.
Okay.
Awesome. Correct.
Next.
Over to you.
Okay. Let now go deeper for each of the purusharthas. Please, next slide.
Next slide, yes.
The term purusha artha, different from Sanskrit, purusha, mean people,
yes, human.
Or human being, and artha mean purpose, objective. So, purusha artha is object of human pursuit or purpose of human being. The purusha artha are a group. The purusha artha are a blueprint for human fulfillment. Working with the help of create satisfying balance, meaningful life at the deepest and most holistic level. This purusha artha offer a way of evaluation of our life and making good decision. Knowing our goal, meaning to our spiritual practice. Remember, we are spiritual being with ultimate goal is spiritual awareness as soul. That is our ultimate goal.
Okay.
For example, we can take a moment and ask ourselves, am I managing my life in a way to support my spiritual growth?
This is the question you ask yourself. Yeah.
Next slide, please.
Next slide.
Let me learn more deep about the first purusha artha on dharma.
Okay. Very good. I like
dharma
that.
Dharma about moral values.
Okay.
Moral values. This dharma means the truth or right way of living. On a grand scenario, it is a cosmic law that create the universe from chaos. Rule the universe, created the universe from chaos. This is on the grand scenario. On an individual level, dharma refers to the true purpose in life or the ethical basis on which man lives his life. Dharma brings stability and order, a lawful and harmonious striving to do the right thing.
Okay.
To be virtuous, to helpful to others, to interact successfully with society. Dharma also being conscious in our action, word, and thoughts that we call integrity. Having compassion and sensitivity to the need of others, because others is part of our life, our brother and sister.
Yes. Being
awake to existence of divine within us. Ultimately, dharma led us to remember who really we are. We are spiritual beings.
Okay.
That is dharma.
That's dharma. Yes.
The second. Yes. Let's go to the second purusha artha. Next slide.
Yes.
Now Artha. Artha is economic values. Dharma Foundation for looking, searching the economic aspect. Artha refers to the security of having material comfortably need to life the world with easy. Artha is not about objecting the world, but being content with the thing you own.
Pa, you are muted. You are muted. You are muted. Your bandwidth. Sorry, yeah. Okay. Continue.
Short connection problem.
Oh. Yeah. Okay.
Artha is one of the basic human dignities. Okay. To have enough asset to life or to taking care our family. Without hoarding or being greedy.
This is very important. Without hoarding or
Chanakya
being greedy.
Chanakya or Kautilya.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Without Dharma, we become greedy person.
Yes, yes.
Economic is important. As Kautilya or Chanakya said in Arthashastra.
Yeah.
Economic as the most important aspect, as it is provide the basic for human existence and survival. Artha not only material in term of the money, but it's also fulfillment life. To meaning, also the means to achieve it. Including knowledge, friendship, love, career, skill, good health, of course, prosperity. Talking about Artha, not only money, but also everything related to the prosperity.
Oh, okay. Here you said it's economic values, but you are saying that it's also about knowledge. It includes knowledge, friendship, love, career, the skills, everything inclusive is Artha. Is that correct?
Yes. Exactly.
All right.
Yes, correct.
Artha is a Sanskrit word, right?
Let's go to the third Purusa Artha on okay. Kama now. Next slide.
Okay.
Kama refer to desire for pleasure and enjoyment.
Okay.
Desire. But a lot of people misunderstanding about kama because Western popularity the kama with regard to the Kama Sutra.
The last.
Most yeah. people. Shortly understand kama only about sex manual. This is misunderstood. Kama is everything related to our pleasure and enjoyment. Life without desire and for pleasure
yeah.
is hollow and empty.
Mm.
Because desire for pleasure is what drives human behavior. Kama related, kama related to this pleasure can be sensuality, but also art, music, beauty, love, intimacy, affection, fellowship, and kindness.
Yes.
Which is bring a sense to delight our life. So simply, kama not only about sexuality, but everything related to desire for pleasure and enjoyment.
Okay.
Okay. The fourth purusa arta. Next slide. Moksha. This is the ultimate goal. Spiritual values. Moksha is derived from the root of Sanskrit moksh, which means free, let go, release, or liberate. Moksha also called vimoksha, vimukti, or mukti, is term in Hinduism and Hindu philosophy refer to various forms of emancipation, liberation, or release. In its sociological and eschatological sense, moksha refers from the freedom from samsara, freedom from cycle of death and rebirth. In its epistemological and psychological sense, moksha refers to freedom from ignorance. Ignorant about who we are. Ignorant about we are spiritual being. When our life, when we live up Dharma in our life, fully supported by Artha, Kama, and Moksha, then final liberation is done.
Okay, so
moksha aspect ultimate goal will down automatically.
Yeah, Ma, I have this. You said that when you are already reaching moksha, that will be your the time when you realize, when you have your self realization, you receive. I mean, you will reach moksha, right? Okay.
Yes.
If a person has not done dharma in his life, first part. If he didn't fulfill that, but he still gets his artha, he still have his desires, and then he will not be reaching his moksha. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Okay. So these four, dharma, artha, and kama and moksha, are they intertwined or are they individual in a self?
Interrelated.
They are intertwined.
These four purusa artha, Dharma, Artha, Kama, and Moksha is interrelated one each other.
Okay.
Dharma is foundation for ethical life. For when we looking for money with ethical basis.
Okay. Okay, go ahead, sir.
Go ahead. Okay, continue. Continue.
One point. One point more on the moksha. Sometimes people saying moksha should be dead first. No. Oh,
die only go to reach moksha.
Yes, die. We should die first, then go to moksha. No. We can moksha also in our life.
Oh, tell us about it.
We can moksha in our life as far we aware, we understand that we are human being practicing, experiencing human experience. We are spiritual being experiencing human experience.
No, in all the scriptures, I think it's only in the Hindu, the Sanatana Dharma speaks about this.
Yes.
Exactly. No other.
Because the other religion, sorry to say, the other religion only teach the ultimate goal is heaven.
Heaven, okay.
According to Hindu, heaven is not our home. Heaven only terminal. All human being will, according to Hindu, all human being will go to heaven, will go to hell, before the moksha. Depend on the karma, depend on the our behavior.
Yeah. Depending on the volume of karma, whether it's big, more, less, how many births over and over and over we have to take.
Yes.
Numerous,
yes.
Several births in order to get there, right? Okay, so you
the
want
only,
to read
the only way to become moksha, be best Hindu, be Hinduism.
Okay.
So okay.
Do we have any questions there?
Any questions?
So far?
Nyaman, Vaidya. Thank you, Pa Arsana. Okay, great, Pa Arsana. Okay. Next one.
Any questions from the participants? Okay.
Questions. People are congratulating you. Great. What else? Want to read?
Okay. I think this one very important. I want to go to the four life stages in the four age. Yeah, four life stages. The Chatur
okay.
Ashrama.
Okay. Okay. This four Purusha Artha is related to our four life stage. We call Chatur Purusha Chatur Ashrama. When we are a student, we should learn something ethically. We should learn Dharma.
Okay.
Because during study, a student, we learn Dharma, so we know we can differentiate which is wrong, which is correct. When go to next level, we go to the second ashrama, which is Grihastha or householder stage. We should looking for money. Artha. Artha for ourselves, artha for our family.
Yes, we need it. We need it.
We need it. We need it. But looking for the artha should based on Dharma.
Dharma. Got it.
There is a question there from Kesh Gopi. Pasana, hold on. There is a question from Kesh Gopi.
Yes.
Is there hell
please
as such in Sanatana Dharma? Is there hell?
Is there hell?
Yeah, is there hell in Sanatana Dharma?
As far as I know, there is hell, there is heaven.
Okay.
But both is only terminal, not home.
Yes, it's like a bus stop.
It's a stopover.
Yes, bus stop. If we go for sightseeing, after sightseeing, we have to go home, not stop in this bus stop.
Yeah, you put it so well. You put it so well.
Okay, so there's hell, but hell is only a bus stop. It's not hell or heaven is only a bus stop. It's not a destination.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
Because to some religions, they would say that if you do bad, you know, you will, God waits there and you will be rotting in hell, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
The God will be waiting to punish. They think that God's punishing them if they don't do things. For in our Hindu Sanatana Dharma,
is a nice word,
God doesn't punish.
Bus stop.
It's a bus stop, yes. Good, we like it.
Okay.
Okay, so move ahead, move on. We have another 10 minutes.
About 10 minutes, we will wrap this up in about 10 minutes, yes.
Yeah.
Our God is not Preman.
Our God is what?
Not Preman. Not criminal.
Oh. Yes. Okay.
I reserve my comment. Yeah. Okay, there is his
level,
feedback on my own. There's a feedback.
To Vanaprastha, can meditate. In this level, we focus on karma and spiritual awareness, moksha. Then go to the next slide, please.
Okay. Thank you, Nagesh ji. Punishment is in hell until finish its time. Yeah. Okay, next slide says what? The five basic needs of every person.
Okay.
Okay. as human being,
yes,
as spiritual being with human body,
yeah,
we have five basic spiritual needs.
Okay.
Yes.
One, meaningful philosophy of life, because we live for a values, for a moral sense. This meaningful philosophy come from Veda. The second, sense of transcendent, a sense of transcendent, outside of self, viewing okay. God and something beyond our life. The third, trusting relationship with God. The fourth, relatedness to the nature and people. Mm. And the last one is sense of life meaning.
A sense meaningful of life. Okay.
Life.
Okay. This sounds like this. Sounds
I will
like,
share the next slide. Is important.
This one very important.
Yes.
So this is a very important yes. one. Yes.
If we remember about moksha,
yeah,
moksha simply is liberation.
Liberation.
Yes.
Okay.
Or I can use the other way, the other word. Moksha mm-hmm. is freedom.
Freedom.
Moksha is freedom. To go to freedom, Hindu give us a freedom way of go to freedom.
Could you repeat that, please?
Moksha is about freedom.
Okay.
To go to freedom, Hindu give us a freedom way.
Okay.
There's a four part of the freedom way. We call Jnana Marga or Jnana Yoga, Karma Marga or Karma Yoga, Bhakti Marga or Bhakti Yoga, and Raja Marga or Raja Yoga.
Raja Yoga,
Raja
yeah.
Yoga, okay.
Life is a journey of Dharma exhaustion.
Okay.
The beautiful journey for sightseeing. But don't forget to go home.
Okay. We forget. We are reminded we need to go home. Cannot do sightseeing alone, huh?
Yes. Don't forget to go home, but don't go to bus stop.
Okay, very good.
Our home is awareness that we are unity, oneness with our creator God, Atman, Brahman, unity. If we focus on jhana, this is about awareness of spiritual unity, Atman yeah. and Brahman.
Yeah.
If we focus with the Karma Yoga, the main idea is do the best with selfless. Work hard with mental rest.
Okay. I would like to stop you for a while, Pak Arsana. There is a comment yes. on my wall. There's a comment Please. On my wall that says, best not to refer humans as donkeys, even for a figure of speech. Everyone has come a long way and self-realization is vital for all, but it is the ignorance. I think we need to stop talking like this. This is a time to be an unapologetic Hindu.
Yes.
Yeah. Arise, Arjuna. Enough being talking about this. Yes. Ahimsa, need to be nice. People don't understand, but people will climb on your head and talk rubbish. And we supposed to be Om Namah and all those kind of things. I think we need to change the mindset. No, we are not aggressive people.
Yes.
Yeah, we are not people of abusive language.
Yes.
But when somebody says anything nasty, about my belief system,
when I don't,
I will not keep quiet. I think enough of being Mr. Nice Guy.
Yes.
Yeah. What is job of Arjuna? When you need to fight, fight.
Time to samhara.
Yeah, I think some. Yes.
Yes.
Come on. It is we call it grandmother statements or mother statements.
Yes.
Yeah, we need to understand.
Think of Arjuna.
Yeah, think of Arjuna.
It was time for him.
This is Dharma rising. Yes. The time has come for us to what? Satyagraha.
Yes.
Push it back to you.
Yes.
You know, we have been sitting back too nice.
And karma will take. Yes.
Taking on whatever people have been saying.
Yes.
To our Dharma. I never say a nasty thing about any people. For me, Vasudeva Kudumbakam. Fine. Yeah. But then, when you say nasty things about my belief, I will reciprocate.
Yes.
In a very nice way.
It is our dharma to protect dharma.
Yes. What did Arjuna say in Kurukshetra?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The time has come.
So the keyword is called unapologetic.
Yes.
When I need to defend, I will defend. But I will not be offensive.
We are in the war field now.
But when I have to be offensive, I will be offensive.
Yes.
Yeah. So, but first is, I will defend. What you think about this, Pa Arsana?
We become nice Hindu sometimes because of we don't understand the complete message of Krishna.
Yes.
Yes.
The complete message about Ahimsa. We only know only half message of Ahimsa. The complete message Ahimsa is Ahimsa Paramo Dharma, Dharma Himsa Tataitacha.
Yeah.
Mean that Dharma is the big purpose. Protecting Dharma is the same important.
It's righteousness to protect Dharma, yes, to protect my country, yes, to protect the good ones.
That there are too many people who are sitting behind a handphone, a laptop, talking that we should do this, we should do that,
yes,
we have been too long like this, the Hindus must do this, the millions of this doing it.
Yes.
There are only a very handful who's standing up and protecting our Dharma.
Yes. A handful have jumped into the war field. We are in the battleground now.
Yeah.
So in the battleground,
yeah,
you're not supposed to do peace talk because you have already done all the peace talk all these years. Yeah. So you are in the right battlefield. Go for it.
And
we have
people,
no choice.
Yeah, when people steamroll on you, don't take it on your face. Yeah. Take it on your chin. It is time for every Hindu out there to protect our Dharma. I am not asking you to go and fight.
Yes.
But start, do something, do anything. It must be positive. It must be relevant. How to be relevant?
Yes.
When you have to say your piece, you say.
Yes. And Dr. Gopi has also written on the board here.
Yeah.
Krishna instructed Arjuna to stand up and fight to defend and preserve Dharma in society.
Yes, that's what we are doing. Yeah. Okay.
So it's my Dharma. To protect my Dharma.
Protect my Dharma. But I never say anything nasty about other people.
Exactly.
Yeah, your belief is your belief. My belief is my belief.
Yes.
We will never say anything bad about other people's belief. No belittling.
Yes.
But this is my belief.
Yes.
Yeah, you don't have any right to say anything nasty about my belief.
Yes. Okay.
Who gave you the right to speak about and nasty about my belief? Did I invite you to speak anything nasty about my belief?
Yes.
Give respect. To get respect, to earn respect. That's all.
Okay, so Pa Arsana, we have another 4 minutes for you to do your closing slides, I think. You've got another one slide or two slides.
Okay, please go to the next slide.
Yeah.
Okay.
Please go to the next slide. I take one slogan. Previous one. Back.
Which one?
The no, leaf. Back.
Behind.
Okay. Right. Stop.
The offering.
I take one sloka from Bhagavad Gita 9:26. If one offer to me with devotion a leaf, flower, fruit, or water, I delightfully will accept it. This Krishna said to Arjuna. God said to human being, let we start with new life, with new meaning, new understanding about our scripture. Live not only the real life, but our body. Use our body, use our energy to share Dharma, to protect Dharma.
Yes.
Flower, do with the full heart, the flower of our heart. Fruit, do the best fruit of our deed, our action. Water is tear of emotion because we can protect Dharma. We do the best for Dharma with gratitude and happiness. It is our responsibility for our own spiritual development. Our physical life gives us the opportunity to develop our spiritual potentiality. Next.
Okay, last slide, I think.
Next slide.
Okay, next one.
Yes.
Is this the one? Is this the one?
No.
Which one? Is there a temple?
Back one more.
Back.
This one.
Offering.
Oh, okay.
Next.
Not the offering one. Or the Hita Karana?
Page 20.
Living in
page
harmony.
Page 20. Okay, give page 20.
Living in harmony. Is that correct?
Living in harmony.
Living yes. in harmony. Okay, yes. Living in harmony. Page 20. Living in harmony.
Yeah, got it. There, I just saw you.
No,
got it.
No.
Okay.
Next one. Yes.
We got it. So you got to run very quickly here, Pa.
He's frozen.
Okay. With regard the Hindu values.
Yeah.
Hindu teach us to live in harmony between ourselves as human being with our God, whatever name, whatever form. Since other people also is part of our life, we should live in harmony between human and human being. Okay. Between human and other human being. At the same time, we also live in harmony with other creators, nature, animal, and everything. Yes. Because we know in that creature also a soul, Atman.
Yeah.
In Indonesia, we call this Trihita Karana, living in harmony with three area. Next.
Okay,
the last slide, I think. Okay, we can...
The last slide.
Yes.
I take from the Ayurveda. You should convey this sacred Vedic teaching to Brahmin, Satya, Vaishya, Sudra, my people, even to stranger in the same way. We should become a spokesperson of Veda.
Yeah. Okay.
And in Indonesia, we have Prambanan Temple.
Yes.
We in the process to get approval from government to use again this temple as Hindu temple. worldwide, globally. Yes. Let's support to come to this temple and spread the values of Hindus.
Yes.
By coming to this temple. Thank you. Om.
Okay.
Santi, thank Santi, you so Santi, much. Om.
Before we close, I mean, some of you also can answer this question from Cash Gopi. Is there an equivalent of fatwa in Sanadana Dharma? Is there an equivalent of fatwa in Sanadana Dharma? The rest of you also can give some feedback on this. Pa, can you give anything of feedback on this? I'm not too sure of this. Is there an equivalent of fatwa in Sanadana Dharma? Is there?
What is the question?
Is there an equivalent of fatwa in Sanadana Dharma?
Fatwa in Sanadana Dharma is we call bisama.
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 Oh, okay. Never heard that before.
B-H-I-S-A-M-A. Bisama.
Okay. Who issues this? Who issues this? Which body?
The higher body in Indonesia, we call this body is Parisada Hindu Dharma Indonesia.
Okay. Parisada.
So that Hindu is Dharma. In Indonesia.
Indonesia, okay.
But it's not a universal thing, or it does not take place in other countries, right? It's
yes.
In Indonesia,
yes.
Right? Okay, related to Indonesia, I also have another question before we wrap up. Pa, could you please throw some light on the division between Bali and India, or the Hindu in Bali, and how to deal with that? Do you have, how are the issues?
Okay, there? good question. Good, very good, very nice question.
Thank
Hindu
you.
Hindu teach us, three aspects of the religion of Hinduism. One is tattva, knowledge. Second is susila, about our ethic behavior. And the third is ritual, devotion practices. Our tattva, our knowledge on Hinduism is the same, based on Veda. These values based on Veda should be shown in our behavior as ethical behavior. But the ritual depend on the local.
Okay.
Ritual in Bali, ritual in India, ritual in Africa, ritual in Sulawesi, ritual in Malaysia can be different. But the values, the knowledge is the same.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
So how are the Hindus in Bali? Are they having any kind of challenges, or how are things moving there?
What is your point of the question?
No. How are the Hindus in Bali?
Yes.
Are there any? How are the challenges there, and how are the Hindus living there? Their lifestyle? Are they all okay? Are they in peace? Do they live in peace, or are they segregated?
If we talk about Bali, Bali more famous than Indonesia. Actually, Bali is part of Indonesia.
Yes, talking
it's
about
famous.
Bali.
It's famous because its values. Its values.
Yes.
Its values. It came from Hinduism.
Yes, exactly.
But with local wisdom of the culture.
So there's a mixed culture that makes it very unique.
Yes, it's blended culture with the yes. Hindu values.
All right.
Since
thank you, Pa.
Since Bali is a nice place because of Hindu values, a lot of destroyer won't come to convert Balinese Hindus.
We are waiting to go back there because we just love to see. We love the culture. We love the smell of Bali, the Indonesian flavors, rich in so many things there.
Mukesh Bhai says, though, no,
but,
sorry. Sorry, Bhai, continue.
If Bali not Hindu anymore, Bali no beauty anymore.
I like that. I like
Bali
that.
Is beautiful because of the Hindus.
Hindu
of Bali.
Values, yes.
All right, thank you. Awesome. Thank you very Hindu. Much, Pa Arsana. Exactly. I would like to also read from Mukesh Bhai here. There's no equivalent of fatwa in Sanatana Dharma. This because it leads more. It leads to more karma, more vasana, and more ignorance. All right. Any closing statement from you? Any closing statement?
My simple statement.
Yeah.
Be proud to become Hindu.
Yes.
Be proud to become Hindu. Learn the Hindu teaching.
Yes.
And share to other people.
Yes.
For other people get the benefit, become Hinduism.
Yes.
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 That's all.
That's
awesome.
Yes.
Awesome. And thank you. Thank you so much.
That's our mission here. Let's spread
thank
this
you.
Energy around. Yeah. Thank you so much. It's so good. So nice to have you here. In fact, we learned a lot today, Sipa. We learned a lot today from you. And we have a lot more to learn. We hope to see you in our next oncoming sessions, maybe second or third or fourth. Another, when we go on another rotation, we'll have you again. And anything else you want to
all
say?
All right. Unfortunately, it seems that the defense requires doesn't Krishna advise adaptation in SBG. All right.
Okay.
Anyway, Gopiji, let's do whatever we can. Yeah, there's a lot of things that is not within our control. Do something which is within our control. I always say do something, do anything.
Yes.
It must be positive. It must be relevant.
Yes.
Expecting others to do something is not within our control.
Exactly.
Do what is within your control and you see transformation happening in Sanatana Dharma. Yeah. All right. With that note, I would like to now tell you all your simple thing you can do is follow this page, like this page,
yes.
Share this page
yes.
Because we want to take this.
Yes.
We want to bring our Hindu brethren from all over the world
yes.
To come in. Today we have about 20 of them watching live. We hope to have 200 people watching at the same time.
Yes.
It is in the hand of every individual out there.
Yes.
So that's the little contribution you can do. You like, you follow, and you share. Get people to come. Every
yes.
Week we do this. Next week, we have about 4 or 5 young Hindus to come and speak.
Yes.
About. It's going to be a forum. It's not going to be somebody talking. It's going to be a forum.
Yes.
And that topic is called spreading your youth energy.
Yes.
Next Saturday. So bring people.
Yes.
Invite them. Let's contribute. That's the smallest little thing that you can do to add value
yes.
To Sanatana Dharma. Instead of saying we should be doing this, it should be doing that. That organization must be doing this. This organization should be. That's enough.
Get
we have been talking
ground.
This
yes.
For many, many years.
Yes.
It is time to spread our energy
yes.
And contribute in every which
yes.
Way
yes.
That you can. With that note, on my part, I'd like to thank every one of you viewers for being
viewers,
with us the
yes.
Last 1 hour and 21 minutes.
Yes.
I also like to thank Pa Arsana from Indonesia.
Yes.
Thank you so much,
thank you.
Pa. And also like to thank my co-host, Krishna
yeah,
Ji.
I'm applying for leave. Can I apply for leave?
Yes, can. Next week, only
next
guys.
Next week, I'm taking leave.
Next week, only guys. We bring all the guys
all right,
to a forum
good.
And just bring some, what do we do moving
all
forward
right,
using
yeah.
The youth energy.
Yes,
yeah?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.
Om Swastiyastu.
Om Swastiyastu.
Om Swastiyastu.
Namaste.
Thank you so much.
Om Shanti.
Om Shanti. Shanti. Thank you.